Hello, my name is Christoph Witte. I'm a freelance IT journalist. I'm here at the booth of the International Software Architecture Qualification Board on the OOP conference in Munich. And today I talk to Frank Pienka. He's a co-founder of the ESAQB, and he is responsible for improving trainings and improving certifications. Frank, why is software architecture so important nowadays?
Oh, thank you, Christoph, for asking and inviting me here. Software architecture, I think it's still important because this is the part it's very hard to change afterwards. So it's important to make your decisions right and to evaluate your decisions you made.
Okay, and what are the most important aspects in training software architects?
Communication, of course, it's the most important part in software development, to get the things right and to get the feedback from the members, if they have understood and understood the way. And so it's more interaction, it's more important in the trainings than front trainings.
And do you consider the soft skills of an architect more important or the hard skills? and what are the hard skills?
Oh, of course, the balance, it's the best of both.
Yeah.
It's one saying that nothing is so practical than a good theory. And that's also a good answer on this. You get a good theory, not too much, but then you can build your practices on it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you need both.
Yeah, short-term and long-term decisions you must make.
Okay, and how does ISAQB help here in bringing software architects up to speed and help them to be good software architects?
Yeah. Nowadays, you have different backgrounds in this position, in this role, so it's important to have a common understanding. For this, I really prefer and like the foundation level from ISAQB, and this was a motivation for me to engage, mm-hmm. because at this time it was not on the market, such training, and I also use it in my company also. So one time a year we have a foundation training for new people and so.
And you just said that the background of the architects changed in the recent years. How did it change? What changed?
Change, it's the only constant in IT, and it changed from the mindset. So we have younger colleagues, we have older colleagues, and to bring both together, we have computer scientists, we have from mathematical background, and also from other science backgrounds, mm-hmm. and that's why we need some additional knowledge.
So they are not more diverse than in former times, but just changed, the background changed.
Yeah, but also perhaps of my age, the diversity of cultures you're coming from.
Okay. So there is more diversity as well.
Diversity intercultural and also from the ages.
Okay.
Yeah.
There seems to be a new trend in software architecture called clean code. Can you comment on that, please?
The coders are the new kingmakers, and the movement, it's a movement coming from Uncle Bob, where he has written a book, Clean Coder, and also this the part you mean perhaps, and the other part is clean architecture, different aspects of the same one. The principles, of course, living longer than the movement, they have just put it in a package. But I will say only clean code doesn't mean you have good software. If you don't look at some quality issues, for example, security.
Yeah.
So it's not automatically you have clean code, it's secure code. So
there must be something
Clean code doesn't need to be good code.
No.
And it's not the code perhaps the customer wanted. Okay. It's more some self-help for the coders, for the programmers.
Okay. And do you feel that Clean Code is an important movement, or is it just a movement?
I think it's some level to learn from other coders how to structure, and that's I like it. Yakni and KISS mm-hmm. always keep it simple, but not too simple. So it's also difficult at this principle to make it simple. It's not so easy. Yeah. So, but you don't have time to make it right all the time, and the time is limited, especially in software development. So you must do compromises. Accepted.
Okay. Will we find new code elements in the trainings of ESA QB?
Of course, there are new technology trends, for example, blockchain, but also what's the role of agility in architecture?
Yeah.
What does it mean for the architect? And also from the architecture style, what does it mean to have a flexible architecture with microservices and so on? So we have special modules who really address these trends and give answers for this. Mm-hmm. And also in the trainings, they have this interaction style that you don't only read something, so you practice it already in the training.
Yeah. So. Okay. And on principle, how do new topics enter into trainings and into curricula? How does that work?
It's also the diversity of our members, and also that they bring the topics they have seen and they work in their project. For example, with the blockchain, quite new topic. But also in my company, we have a technology radar. We always look at it and so, and we see what others have accepted and adapted, and so what can work for us and for our customers. And perhaps you can make a training out of it then.
Okay, and so the trainings are adopted over time.
Yeah, it's afterwards.
Okay. So. Okay.
And it's evolutionary. It can be that some trainings work now and in 5 years. So there are other topics and you must adapt it or have new training to a new trend. Yeah.
What last question. What is the most important characteristic of a training from your point of view?
The day after the training, it's the most important day.
What you remember, or what you remember on the training, or why, or what you can use? Yep.
Because what you don't write down or practice the day after the training, so it will be lost in next week and the next month and next year. And so it's good to make a practice out of the training. One point, just to take one point, not too much. And so, and this is satisfying for you.
Okay, thank you very much, Frank. And thank you for your time and interest. And please keep in mind what Frank said. The most important thing on a training is the day after. Thank you.